So I'm not going to spoil it just yet, what we're about to see. But to get there, oh, this is so cool. Oh my God, okay, hopefully we'll get closer to this mountain. Pass it. You can see the snow on the top of the mountain. I mean, that cold. It's that cold. What I was saying? Yes, so it's going to be a very exciting day today. We're going to see a lot of exciting things. Town looks old, right? Really cool. I think this will be the last town actually on our route today, because we are going sort of into the wild and we'll be camping tonight and tomorrow night, most likely for free. The temperature dropped down. We're already on what? Elevation 1,700. And we're only gonna go up, I think. So it is chilly now. Just a quick stop for gearing up. So here we can see snow from close. Ah, so windy, oh my God. So it's the beginning of March. That's why you can still see snow. And we're on, at the moment, 2000. Oh my God, the wind, Jesus. Our elevation at the moment is 2200, so we're quite high. I just saw a deer. It was just like running through the road here. Okay, no one else? Okay, good. I'm going to Gila Cliff Dwellings. So as usual, I haven't done much research, but apparently it's a UNESCO site. I hope there won't be too much walking involved. And I hope I'll be able to camp there. I overland had some spots marked not too far away from there. Wow, right? What a beautiful view. Okay, let's see what's going on here. I guess we could park Chili here at the end. And we are all set up. Tent is ready, just here. Chili is up the back there. I couldn't bring her here. I covered her because now it's time to go for a walk and see this epic site. Apparently it's like 1 hour walk.
up to 2 hours depending on the stops, I guess, but I can do this. Now I don't have the, you know, riding gear. Let's do it. So the whole hike is like 1 mile long. Oh, I know, and that's okay, it's not too far, but apparently there's some steep steps involved. It's okay, we've got water, we will be just fine, Kingo, we'll be just fine. Well, we can already see Cliff Dwellings from here. So we're gonna go all the way. How are we gonna get there? Now we're doing the stairs. Whew. There's a lot of them. Are we there yet? Wow. This is very beautiful. I think we made it. All right, I'll fix my hair, this is an important moment. Okay, so we are ready for a little narration. So, this place. This was home of Mogollon people in 1200, so, you know, 800 years ago, something like that. And no one really knows why they left. They just took off and they were gone. So I'm not sure how long they were living here, but it's very impressive how they built it because they used clay, they used rocks, and it's so high up. Look, look at the view, they really... the access wasn't that easy, you know what I mean, to get to them. So yeah, interesting. Maybe it's just like an apartment complex. And we got to the end of the trail. End of the trail. I think that's what's the door. We're like crawling in. Probably. It looks like there were had pipes for water. Clever, right? They were clever people. I'm so impressed. That was so, it was really worth it. Back to the base camp. Today's dinner, oranges. That's it. I'm not that hungry. I had a big lunch. That was a good day. I really enjoyed that walk. Maybe I should be walking more. Yeah, note to myself. Walk more without the riding gear. Hopefully it won't be too cold at night. There is a possibility it will be. I think it's time for Netflix and bed. Morning. I have to share something with you. This is so important. I just discovered something magical. Okay, so last night we had around 0 degrees. It was really chilly. And my gear, unfortunately, not my gear, my mattress is just not good enough. So you remember when my stuff got stolen in Canada? So I just, in Newfoundland, I went to the camping shop and I bought the mattress, whatever was available. It's a thermarest mattress. It's okay when the weather is okay, but when it's around zero, I get really cold from the ground and there's nothing I can do. So I'll show you my setup. So I use a liner. I use Kumul's sleeping bag. It's warm, but like I said, if I'm getting cold from underneath, there's nothing can help. And I also have a BB. And with even all of that, I still get cold. So yesterday, I went to the park shop and I bought this. This emergency blanket is as wide as my tent, so pretty much, yeah, use it as a tarp. It's like that on the other side. It just made such a big difference. I was not cold at all. What a great night. Best $8 ever spent. Period.
And we're good to go. Okay, so the plan for today is, first things first, we're going to Hot Springs. And then we'll see. Bye! They were not my neighbors, they were super nice. Okay, chilly. Another day, another adventure. Oh my god, your tire is so flat. Okay, we're here. This is cool, hey? What a beautiful location. Horses! So cool. Oh, little goats. Too cute. You'll never guess what happened. They have a spot for me, so I'll be staying here for one night. We're just lucky chilly. And our campground was like on the left, number 10. Look at that chili. Aren't we lucky today? Perfect. Beautiful.
So I'm setting up my tent with my little trick. This emergency blanket just fills up the whole floor. So good. It's gonna be warm night tonight again. Oh, this is the life, I tell ya. I don't know what the temperature is, but it's quite warm. I'm so pleased I got a camping song. So we have 3 poles here. And this one is empty, so I'm recording. A few hours later, I actually went to the hot springs like twice. I feel so relaxed. This place is just unbelievable. I mean, just the location, hot springs, and just everything. I really needed that break. This doesn't happen often, but I'm gonna have a fire tonight. So my little tiny fire is nearly ready. I think we got it. So this is how cold the night was. Chilly is a bit frosty. I'm so pleased I had this emergency blanket on the floor. Are you ready to be on my YouTube? Right? How's my hair? How's my hat?
Your hair is beautiful!
It was freezing! At night, so this is Augie. Augie is a host here at the campground. Augie, originally, where are you from?
I am from Los Angeles.
From Los Angeles, that's right.
Yeah.
But you moved around the states. You were living in Wisconsin for a while, right?
In Wyoming.
In Wyoming.
In the Wind River Mountains.
And now you're here.
I drove that big blue bus down here, and it's my next chapter in my life adventures here.
That's right. So we are going now to see Augie's bus.
It's a 1991 Bluebird school bus that got converted into a home, and I've been working on it for 16 years and living in it for 16 years.
Wow.
Yeah, and I would drive the bus back and forth.
So the bus is still running?
Well, yeah.
Yeah, of course.
And
sounds like you're really happy here. It is a magic place.
It is. It's a spiritual happy place. Mm. And the type of people we meet here.
I know, right?
The type of people that we meet here, man, is like, oh my, how would I ever meet you?
That's right. This is so cool.
So a lot of young girls like to come to the bus and they like to draw pictures on the bus.
Right.
So this is their art.
Very nice. And you're in.
Bus.
Yes.
And I would like to meet my family from Colorado.
Yeah. Oh, you've got a bus driver. My little sticker is here. Yes. Perfect. Okay. Wow. This is amazing. You've got so much space. It's like a proper house. Oh my God, it keeps it so warm, right?
Yeah, that keeps it pretty warm, but I also have, because they piped hot water in here.
Okay.
And
this is your little studio where you work.
I have 120 degree water that comes in here.
And that's
and a geothermal heater. You can feel it pumps out hot air in here.
That's incredible.
And it's all free from the hot water, and it blows out hot air from the water.
Right.
So between that and this, it's so cozy in here all the time.
Wow.
You can tell I do a lot of craft.
Yes, tell us about that. What
so
do
I do a lot of jewelry and feather work. I make feather earrings, and I have so many musical instruments.
You do.
And
all this woodwork you did yourself? Everything?
So when I decided to do this, I had to have help, like with the cabinets and the shower stall.
Mm-hmm.
So this is the back bedroom. This is the loft up here.
Yes.
And many people have stayed here because they get really cold up here, and so I have to save them. So, and I carve drums. I take buffalo hides and elk hides, and I make drums. So the shower stall, I have hot water, the 120 degree water that comes in here.
Yes, connects it, and then
I just turn the little valve on, and it's this tank that's made out of fiberglass,
right.
Carbon fiber, and I fill it up, and you have your shower.
So clever.
And it's all free.
That's right.
My electricity comes from solar panels.
Mm.
My heat comes from geothermal water and wood. And I have internet in here. I have a phone landline.
Yeah.
And it's all free.
Yeah.
Because I work here.
Yeah. Oh my goodness. But this is so amazing. Thank you for this little tour around your house. Honestly, I'm so, so impressed with you. So long, my friend.
Love you, Kinga.
Love you too. Okay, and we're good to go. That was such an amazing place to stay at. So long, my friend.
My friend Bo.
Yes, I did. He's so nice. Look after yourself. It was so nice to meet you.
So nice to meet you.
Have a great day.
You also.
Until next time. That was such an amazing experience. Okay, so we are now going not too far today. Well, actually, it's 40 miles away, but Google said it's like 1 hour and 20 minutes to get there. We're going to Silver City because I need to charge my batteries, I need to pump my tires, I need to work on my YouTube video because I need to post it tomorrow. And then tomorrow we'll cross to Arizona. The road, I guess. Oh, the explosion is wrong.
There, there's my tent.